ordering you people to get up and leave. And I am a sworn, excuse me, I'm a sworn traffic officer. Thank you. I'm a sworn traffic officer and I'm ordering you people to leave. If you don't leave, then you're disobeying a traffic officer and I will have you placed under arrest. That's totally separate from the gentleman.
On Friday, August 20th, activists once again staged spontaneous acts of resistance at the corner of Fell and Divisadero to make the community aware that city streets in San Francisco are still unsafe for bicyclists.
Break the city laws when the city laws aren't protecting us against injury or death on city sidewalks. So, and when the government is not making BP or any other oil companies clean up what they've done in the Gulf of Mexico. So they're not protecting us. I'm not obeying their laws today.
Stuart, why are you out here? A box with a U-lock around your neck, risking arrest, blocking the Arco station here on Fell Street.
The issues are just so important. From global warming to the BP oil spill to cyclist safety here on Fell Street. And, we're trying to fix the problem ourselves through direct action because we're tired of waiting for the government to fix things for us.
And this action brought out Supervisor Ross Mirkarimi, who had this to say about the dilemma of making city streets safer for bicyclists and pedestrians.
This is our district, the 5th district.
Yeah!
It happens to be, in my opinion, probably about the hippest district in San Francisco.
Right.
I get in a little trouble for saying that, but it's unsafe for bicyclists and pedestrians. And when I came into elected office in 2005, we really did declare war that we would make this area, the corridor of Fell, especially going to Masonic, especially as it intersects with the Wiggle, that we would make it safe for bicyclists. We have pressed on the city attorney's office, and they have sent a number of letters to these two businesses right here, where we have done just about everything legally we possibly could to try to shut down these curb cuts right here. Fill them back up. This is contributing to the safety hazard that has been chronic for many, many years. Also, Octavia Boulevard, the much celebrated Octavia Boulevard, and I was part of the fight in the 1990s in bringing down the Central Freeway, the blowback from the traffic that backs up from Fell and Oak requires a more comprehensive understanding how that impacts bicyclists and pedestrians. So this patchwork planning in dealing with bicycle needs has got to stop.
Joshua Hart explains the situation.
My name is Josh Hart. I'm one of the organizers of Fix Fell. I'm here blocking the left turn lane, but temporarily I think it's okay because the sidewalk's really narrow. This is the 11th straight week that people have been out here protesting. And thank you to everyone who's been out here every week demanding that the city make this corridor safe for cyclists and close the gap between the Wiggle and the Panhandle.
Yeah.
So there's a problem here. And the problem is that we prioritize the storage of private motor vehicles, AKA parking, and access to cheap oil over the safety of cyclists and pedestrians here on Fell Street. This traffic corridor was built in the 1950s as a traffic sewer with one goal, to move large amounts of vehicles through this corridor. And as a result, we have deaths and we have injuries, like the poor German tourist, 21-year-old German tourist who was murdered on Masonic on Friday. The city could have done something to prevent that, provided safe, separated bike routes on Masonic, what advocates have been demanding for years, and yet they've failed. Rajiv Bhatia, who works for the Department of Public Health, was comparing the situation of poor traffic engineering to that of a doctor who fails to use the best and latest medicine to treat patients. That doctor would be sued for malpractice, and yet traffic engineers who know what to do, who know how to make our streets safe so that people don't lose their lives, just keep their jobs. We need to hold our elected representatives accountable. We need to hold the Department of Public Works and the MTA accountable for the deaths and the injuries that are occurring on our streets. And we need to make our streets safe for those who are trying to use less oil in their lives.
One of the activists who was locked down explains why he is doing this.
We're cyclists. Safety is being jeopardized by the pressure of the car industry, of the oil industry, of city government wanting to make this public street a priority for cars over cyclists.
I don't want to arrest you, but I'm going to have to if you keep doing it, all right? Thank you. Hard.